executive session, and I want to raise just those three things that I believe are a message to take home. One is action. Let us be seen in action, doing what we say it is possible to be done. Let's skill young people for the future. Let's skill young people to create capacity in the water sector. And my own further contribution is that from our side, we're training 15,000 young people as artisans, some of them as water ambassadors, to amongst others do advocacy work, but create the capacity for the work around the water and sanitation infrastructure maintenance. And the EWCTA that I was referring to is the one that is doing that on behalf of government. And I'm sure we can then build that army for us in Africa and share, also using the other universities and the capacity. And for me, it's the call to action that we must really be dealing with. The second one is around the issues around mine water. There is an opportunity also to partner with the private sector. Let's again open up and see how best we can do in dealing with that resource and ensure that it is actually available for further reuse, because that is the theme for this particular World Water Week. And I'm sure our own agency from South Africa, I don't see them here, TCTA, they can actually be better placed in line with the launch of that atlas that Desigan was speaking about. Work has already been done. We're now investing on the long term, and what we need is the financial support in terms of giving the capacity to our municipalities to take that water and provide to the private sector. The last issue is what is important. Innovative solutions must not be seen as not being conventional. And I think that's what we are stuck with. What we perceive as being conventional is what has been used in the past. And what is supposed to be done and used now is seen not to be conventional. The future must be based on what has been created now, so that then it can be sustainable. Because even that is referred to as being conventional was not conventional at some point. So I'm proposing that let's do that, and our own regulatory environment must be the one that is sorted out to embrace innovative solutions. Young people, women, the face of the woman must never move away from everything that we're doing in line with what has been presented here, but also understanding their role in terms of dignified sanitation as well as drinkable water solutions. Thanks.
Pour conclure, je voudrais moi retenir trois points. La première, surtout, c'est de croire en notre capacité. Puisque déjà, nous avons vu, nous pensons que nous avons la capacité que nous devons échanger. Le deuxième, c'est apporter l'appui, parce que je dirais, aux entrepreneurs de déchets. C'est-à-dire que créer un environnement propice à ce que nous développions donc un entrepreneuriat autour de cette question. Et le troisième point, c'est la promotion, c'est de promouvoir effectivement les échanges interuniversitaires pour que nous puissions donc arriver à nos objectifs. Voilà très certainement ce que je peux dire par rapport à nos échanges de ce matin, qui pourraient être un peu
Merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Ministre. Merci.
Thank you very much. I think my own concluding remark is that let's continue to think outside the box. Let's continue to do things differently. Let us believe in ourselves. Let's believe in the homegrown solutions that we have. As was mentioned yesterday, let us continue to think globally but act locally. Africa is the continent to watch. We will grow. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Now, it will be my pleasure and honor to invite His Excellency Mohamed Abdelatif to close the session. You're welcome, sir.
I'd like to thank you all for attending this session, and also my colleagues, panelists and presenters, and the moderator, Kanesis, AMCOW Secretary General. Actually, the outcomes and the ideas that have been raised, I think they are considerable and will make a change in the performance of AMCOW activities in the next period, either in short, medium or long term. The key thing that we need to see that we have challenges, but all of us together, we can convert these challenges into opportunities. Whenever you have a country that has only 5% access to safe water and sanitation, this means that there are 95% who doesn't have access. These are projects, these are opportunities for all of us, either within the continent or outside the continent, to come and help and invest, and these are opportunities. Whenever we have untapped resources, these are opportunities. So we have the challenges, but together, we work together, we exchange knowledge, we share experience, we encourage youth, we encourage centers of excellence. I think we can do a lot. Thank you very much.
Ministers, thank you very much, everyone. Let me give you a rendezvous, comme on le dit en français, for the Africa Waterway in next summer, in July 2018. You are welcome to Libreville, Gabon. Thank you very much.